Hey, what's up, guys? I'm hanging out today with Cody from Cody's Lab. He just went down to the coin shop and bought some of these 90% junk silver coins because we're gonna melt these things down and see if we can turn them into genuine silver bullets. What would you actually use a silver bullet for other than killing a werewolf? I don't know, but that's what we're gonna do today. Let's get to it. Apparently there's a lot of different ways that you can melt down silver. Now if you're on Cody's channel, you could be using some weird experiment like making silver thermite to do this.
Yeah, use a chemical reaction to melt the silver.
But since we're in my basement today, I'm going to be using the mini arc furnace. It's very small, very compact, and we can get this thing to extreme temperatures. So there you go, guys. Backyard bullet making 101. Here we go.
All right.
Now to make an identical copy of our bullets in silver, I'm going to be using some of this Petrobond sand. It holds together extremely well and it'll take the shape of our bullets. Now we're going to put this wooden retaining wall around it and sprinkle some of the sand and pack it down nice and tight to create our molds. Alright, you can see how well that sand is packed in there. Now theoretically, if we pull those plugs out, we should have little molds.
Oh, look!
Did they come out?
Yeah, it actually all stuck together.
Brilliant. I kind of wish I would have had this stuff when I was making my silver molds.
All right, guys, the time has come. We have got everything set up. We've got our molds here ready to go. We've got our arc furnace carved out and ready to go. And here we've got our carbon electrodes ready to be fired up.
There's the coins.
I think we're just gonna melt the coins right in there because that'll give us the option to pick this up and pour it exactly where we want it to go. So we got our silver coins in the arc furnace. Now all we have to do is put on the lid and fire this thing up. Like so.
Oh, my card came broke.
I snapped it a bit early. What's cool is those coins are almost melted already. I don't know if you can see that. There you go. You can see that.
Whoa! My bad. That's metal.
There we go. Check that out, guys. The coins are almost melted, and that was only about 25 seconds, but unfortunately my carbon rod broke. So we're gonna do a quick repair and get back into it for a second try.
I might be able to just melt this without the lid on it.
So? Check this out, guys. So even without a lid, we got this thing completely molten. That is glowing orange, and it's ready to be poured. It's like the oil in the sand is burning.
Yeah.
Here we go. We at least got one more bullet out of that. Let's give that a little bit of time to cool down, and then I guess we can chop those bullets out of there. What do you think of my arc furnace?
That is hot.
This has cooled down enough to the point where I can touch it, so I think we can go ahead and dig these bullets out. Over here we got Cody's bullet from his thermite reaction. Looks like we got a couple of reasonable casts. Throw those in some water. Yeah. Cody's is gonna be pure silver, and that actually turned out really nice.
Yeah, it's a little rough, the gun will still fire it.
Here's how our silver coin bullets turned out. You can see the shape is pretty good. They're a little bit crude. After sanding and polishing, that's what we got. Cool little silver bullet. Okay, measuring the weight, we got our copper bullet weighs in at about 124 grains, exactly. Our silver bullet weighs in at 94 grains. So it's a little bit lighter, which means it's gonna go a little bit faster. So check it out, guys. This is the original 9mm bullet used for my Glock 19. And these are our silver bullets reloaded into the same casings. The bullets are a little bit lighter weight than the lead, but they should work just fine. All right, check it out, check it out. Now just to do things right, we came out here with a silver bullet and a handgun and a werewolf target. We're gonna shoot this thing just to see if it actually works or not. I don't know if it's the safest idea, but we're gonna give it a shot for your viewing entertainment.
Hey, it worked!
What? So check it out, apparently our improvised silver rounds actually do work. How cool is that? Let's check out the damage.
You hit him?
I think I grazed his shoulder there. Question is if we can recover the bullet. Looks like it's wedged down in there a little ways, isn't it?
Didn't come out the back, so
cool.
It's in there.
We may be able to recover that. Ooh, that does have some kick to it.
Yeah, it actually made it through the wood, see that?
Oh, it came right through. Oh, dang. Our silver bullets are powerful.
Where did it go?
There it is.
Dude, no way! Check it out! That actually looks surprisingly intact.
Yeah, it looks like it's got a little bit of riflings in it.
How cool is that, guys? We could almost take that back and reload it and shoot it again. This is my favorite silver bullet. It came out really nice. You know, it looks really shiny. It is a little bit pocked, but is that gonna make a difference to the way it shoots? We're gonna find out right now. Yeah, right through the face. Look at that, right through the schnoz. Actually looks like his mouth is open now. That's cool.
That was silver, it would've got him.
All right, Cody, what do you got? What are you doing here?
So this is the pure silver bullet, the short and stubby one. Should still work though, right?
This is the one that we made with this thermite reaction. Eat precious metals. Check it out, look at the damage. I think it'd be going down after a shot like that. Definitely went into the wood there, cool.
Let's split it open and see how they look.
Doesn't get much better than that.
I see one there.
Oh, sweet, sweet. Let me check it out.
So it went from here to here. That's
a reasonable distance.
Yeah.
It actually looks like it's in really good condition.
Yeah, the wood kind of polished it even.
Comes out shinier than when it went in.
Yeah, it's the stubby one.
That's our pure silver.
Yep.
Yay! Precious metal bullet recovered. Okay, our silver rounds worked and we were able to recover two of the bullets from inside of that stump, which it's really impressive the condition that these things are in. I mean, they're a little bit rough, but almost could just polish them up and reload them and use them again.
They didn't have like a lead core, so they didn't mushroom or anything. They just went in and stopped.
I think they'll do well for the purpose they were designed for.
So we have had some success. We made silver bullets from nothing but some silver coins.
Silver coins.
And a mini arc furnace. We melted them down, used a sand mold. They came out a little bit crude, but you know what? We now have some fully functional werewolf deterrent, which we may or may not ever have to use, but it was a lot of fun.
It was.
So big thanks to Cody for coming and hanging out today. This was great. Cody's lab, go check him out. He's got a lot of experiments with chemicals that I can't pronounce. And also on his channel, you're gonna see the thermite reaction he did with silver oxide. It is like pure silver, is it not?
This would be fine silver.
Fine silver, so that's awesome. Go check him out, Cody's lab. Thanks for joining us in this video, guys. We'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then.
That's